Okay, so in this video, we just want to talk about derivatives of exponential log functions. We'll do a couple examples. So the base information that you need looks like this. One, the derivative of, we usually start with the natural log. Derivative of e to the x is just e to the x. And then the derivative of natural log x is 1 over x. And your book gives derivations of these, but this is kind of the information we'll use. And then also in a separate context, the derivative of b to the x, these exponential functions of a different base than the natural base. You'll notice the natural base derivatives are really simple. But the derivative here is b to the x times natural log of b. And the derivative of log base b of x is 1 over natural log, oops. 1 over the natural log of b times 1 over x, which also simplifies to be 1 over x natural log b. Oops, hold on, I'm switching my b's and my x's, but that's a natural log b. This one is an x there. Okay, so I just want to do some examples. These are pretty straightforward, and all of those things about kind of the power rule, how derivatives work for sums. Things like that still hold, and this constant multiplier rule especially. So, let's just do a couple examples. Okay, let's do a couple examples. So find f prime, find the derivative of f of x is equal to 5 e to the x plus 3 x. So again, the sum rule says that I can look at these because these two terms that I identify as being able to take the derivative of are separated by a plus. I can take them piece by piece. So I'll take this one, and the derivative, and this 5 is a constant multiplier out front. So the 5 stays there, and then I take the derivative of e to the x, which is just e to the x. Okay? I know it looks weird. It looks like you haven't changed it. You took the derivative. Okay. Plus, and then this 3 is a constant multiplier, and the derivative of x, if you'd use the power rule, the power here is 1. So the 1 comes up forward, really, and you get x to the 0. The power rule works, but 0 is also 1. So this final answer is 5 e to the x plus 3. Okay? Okay. Same thing. Let's do an example with, oh, natural log. I want to do one of these. F of x, find the derivative. Find f prime of x for f of x is equal to, and let's say it's oh, good. 4x squared plus natural log x to the 8th power. And so I don't know yet. Later on, we'll talk about the chain rule and whether or not we can apply that. But again, I have these two pieces, and I'll look at them separately. So the derivative of 4x squared, I use the power rule. So, and the 4 is this constant multiplier, so I have a 4 out front. The 2 comes out from the exponent, x, and I subtract 1 from the exponent, and I get 1. Plus, and now, okay, so before I do this, before I take the derivative, because this line will be f prime, I'm going to rethink this natural log and remember the power rule here, which is moves this 8 out front and makes it a constant multiplier instead of a derivative. So then from here, I can put 8, and then the derivative of natural log is 1 over x. Okay? So then I get 8x plus, and then I would probably combine these and put 8 over x like this. And that's what you get. Okay? Okay. So let's do a couple more examples with these. With kind of the other type, not base E problems. So for example, find, using this other language, dy dx, another derivative, 4 y is equal to, and let's say 3 log base 5 of x. Okay, and so I remember, and I don't really need you guys to memorize this, so the plan is to give this to you on the exam, like as a note. 1 over natural log b times 1 over x. The e to the x and the natural log derivatives you should know. This, I don't mind giving you. So when I take the derivative of y with respect to x, this, again, 3 is a constant multiplier and will just come down. And then this is the piece that I use kind of this rule on. So, and in this case, b is 5. Do you guys identify that as the base of this log? So this is 3 times, and the first piece is 1 over natural log 5, and then times 1 over x. So if I combine these, I would probably put 3 on the top, x in front, and natural log 5. Just to kind of, sometimes, and I want to show this, the other way you might write this is 3 natural log 5 times x, and sometimes when you do that, it's kind of, it looks like the x is inside the log, and usually if there's a multiplier on top of, beside a log, we'll put it out front. Okay? Let's do one more. Find dy dx for, and let's say, y is equal to x to the fifth minus 5 to the x. Okay, and so this is again one of these places where classification comes into play, because here this first one uses just the plain power rule, and this one here I need to use the exponent rule, because I recognize this x in the exponent makes this an exponential function. Okay, so when I take the derivative here, I'll take it again piece by piece, dy dx, and the derivative of x to the fifth is 5x, and then subtract 1 to the fourth, and then minus, and I use this rule for 5 to the x, which says d by dx of b to the x is b to the x natural log b. Okay, and so b in my problem is, again, is here, 5. This is the base. I don't want you guys to think that the base is also 5. I've randomly picked 2 problems where the base is 5, but it's because of what the number is here in the log and what the number is here in the base. If this number was 4, then my base would be 4. Does that make sense? In fact, let's do that kind of altered problem. Okay, just so that we can think about that. Okay, so I changed the problem a tiny bit, and then I want to think about this. Okay, so this is b to the x, and I want to take the derivative. So I get just, again, 4 to the x, and then times natural log of 4. Again, I probably would still write this multiplier out front. That's my preference. So I would probably write natural log 4 to the, you know what? That's a good question, because we, I don't know. All right. It's a weird thing, because with exponential functions, we also usually write the multiplier out front, but with natural logs, we usually write this out front. So maybe either place is fine. You do need to distinguish what's inside the natural log and what's outside the natural log. So yeah, I would say in that case, this one here might actually be the clearer notation. I might change my mind. Is that okay? Okay. So some of these things are judgment calls. You want to be kind of clearly communicating to your audience what's there. And down here, I think this could be interpreted as natural log 4 times 4 to the x in kind of this mushed together way. Okay. The other thing that you'll see in this chapter is that we begin to talk about kind of application problems, and so the key word that you'll use in application problems to indicate the derivative is rate, or also change, or also instantaneous change. So we look at those things. You'll also start to see the introduction of other words, business kind of equivalents for the derivatives. So for example, marginal cost is just the derivative of cost, marginal profit is just the derivative of profit, marginal revenue the derivative of revenue. So you'll see kind of those keywords start to play a role in what's happening. Okay, let me know if you have questions.